Well, folks, we have a treat tonight. If you never met Dano before, one thing I can say about tonight, if you get a chance to talk to him, you will go away feeling like you've known Dano all your life. Dano has just got that kind of personality. The joy that you bring with you is brotherhood. You're just like a brother from the first time I met you. And that first time I met him, that's what it felt like. I came away feeling like I've known him for a long time. And if you've just seen him on Facebook, you hadn't really met him. He is a very special, gifted man that God uses. He has a heart for serving Christ. And tonight he's going to bless us with a message. So folks, give it up for Dano.
I guess red light's on means I'm on. That. Hook me up, bro. You don't have to get this on camera. Like that. Ew, who had that on? No. All right, so what do? Just sit back here, stand back here, or something? Yeah, I think I'll pull me up the chair here. Well, I think the first thing we need to do is open this up in prayer. That's always a good thing. Dear Heavenly Father, we praise you. We thank you for this evening, Lord. We pray that Dana will just shut up and that you'll speak through me, Lord. Use my tongue as a ready rider to say what you'll have me to say to the people here tonight. Lord, just anoint their ears to hear what the Spirit has to say, Lord. And we just thank you, we praise you for all these things. Give us all a safe ride home to our destinations. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, well, I got this all in old man print and size 16 font so I can read it without my glasses, hopefully. But for all y'all that, I've seen a lot of your faces before, some of y'all I ain't, but I'm sure you've probably read Franco's cartoons, The Sheddites. Everybody know what I'm talking about, right? I mean, this is The Shed, so The Sheddites should know. Okay, well, you know why I'm here then. Okay, this is remedial biker training for The Sheddites. ACA Biker 101, okay? Outside the parking lot, I did have this written out that there was a motorcycle. I am very proud of you guys. I mean, I think I could throw these away. It's full of bikes, man. So, to the Sheddites. Yeah, I was going to tell you, if you ever hope to be a biker, that you need to ride one of them once in a while. And job. and I wasn't really going to teach you about how to be bikers, how to navigate the roads out there, because being a biker really ain't that important in the scheme of things. And it ain't about Dano, it ain't about Mikey, it ain't about Church USA or the Heaven Saints or the Sheddites. It's about El Shaddai. That's what it's about. What really counts is that you know how to ride down the road of life here with Jesus Christ as your road captain. He's the one who we need to follow on this great adventure called life. And you know, I usually start our, you know, whenever I speak, which ain't often, you get what you pay for. I'm impressed that y'all taking up a love offer. That's pretty cool. Here it goes. This is a story. I heard about out riding country road, and they pulled off the side to stretch their legs. It's like, you know, they're getting a little tired, and they're out in country. Pull up this one place, and it's like a deserted farm place, you know. And the only way you could tell it's a farm, the roof of the barn was caved in, but there was birds pecking in the dirt, and there was an old boot wandering around. And, not that. That's a young goat. as they entered the yard, you know, they're looking around. They see an old well. You know, back in the day, people used to draw water out of the wells and everything. They look down and says, man, I wonder how deep that thing is. And other biker says the other one says, hey, let's find something, drop down. You know, we used to drop stones down, you know, old wells and holes and listen for it to hit. Well, it wasn't nothing out there. I mean, it was like abandoned pretty much. Seeing this old transmission, so they both haul it over, throw it over the edge. It took a while before it hit. They said, deep in there. Suddenly they heard something coming at them. They turn around. Here comes this old goat. He's got his head down, horns towards him. Get ready to run him over. And sure enough, the goat, they part like this, and the goat goes right over the edge, right down the well. And they're like looking at each other in amazement. What the heck just happened? They just couldn't believe it. And then this old farmer comes up around the corner. They start talking, shooting the breeze, and they find love the Lord. And they're both the bikers. So they say, that's pretty cool. And, you know, they get ready to leave. The farmer says, hey, by the way, have you seen my goat? They says, heck yeah, that thing almost killed us. Says, you need to have that thing tied up. And, you know, it's too late. The thing's dead. But farmer says, I thought I had him tied up to an old transmission. Ooh. Well, that goat, he was tied to something that pulled him down, way down. Oh, you know, what are we tied to? What you're tied to, that's what you're going to follow. I mean, the poor goat, I mean, feel sorry for him, but he was tied to that. Are you tied to your motorcycle? Are you tied to your work? Are you tied to alcohol, drugs? Are you tied to distractions of life? Are you tied to Jesus Christ? If y'all got your Bibles with you, I'm going to read out of John 15, verses 1 through 11. I got my Bible in my pocket, but I got it in big print right here. So, John 15, verses 1 to 11. Everybody say amen or something when you're there. Amen. All right. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears prunes, that it may bear more fruit. You're already clean because of the word which I've spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in me, and I without me, you. If anyone does not abide in me, he is branch is withered, and they gather them up and throw them in the fire. Abide in me and my words abide in you. You will ask for what you desire and it shall be. Father is glorified that you will be my disciples. As my Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken unto you that my joy may remain in you and that your joy may be full. Let's pray again. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the reading of your word, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that it don't matter what I say. It matters what your word says, Lord Jesus. And we just thank you for that word going forth and accomplishing that purpose which it was set forth to do. In Jesus' name. Chapter 15, verse 5, he talks about he is the vine. We are the branches. You know, he's saying that you're tied to him. And that jar strength. That's what sustains us when life is tough. You know, I heard going through stress and everything at work and all that. I mean, I go through a lot of stress at my job, too. Y'all wouldn't believe it. I ain't going to bore you with the details. But with him, we can do all things because he strengthens us. And the purpose for being tied with Christ is to live a productive life, bearing fruit. Remain in me, and I will remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. If a person remains in me and I in him, he will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. And in other words, the purpose of our being connected to Christ is that we live productive lives. You know, he's talking about the vine and the branches. If you take them branches off, I mean, it's not going to bear any fruit. It's us. If we get disconnected from him, how can we bear fruit? It's because of him that we can do what we're doing. It says, now why should we live productive lives? I mean, well, it tells us in 15:11 that he's told us this, that our joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. We are connected to Christ so we might live productive lives and find true joy. Again, the branch is hooked up to the tree. I mean, think about it. You can cut the trees off, the branches off. You can prune it, make it grow bigger and everything. But what happens to those branches once they're gone? They're kindling. I mean, that's it. Now, what's the formula for staying connected with them? All right, if you listen carefully, too many Christians miss this formula, which is found in the 14th and 15th chapters of John. It's the principle of love and obedience. John says in verses 9 through 10, as the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you obey my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have obeyed my Father's command and remain in his love. You know, the thing is, a lot of us have love, but are we willing to share it with others? There's a world that's dying and going to hell out there, and all they need to do, they need to hear somebody share that, like Jay Bird going out to these prisons. I mean, he might be the only Jesus some of them might ever see. I mean, when Goat was talking about lifting up the lost souls in that prayer bucket, I believe he heard from God on that. I mean, because that's what it's all about. I mean, if we keep ministering to the church body, what good are we doing? We're not obeying the great command, the commission to get out there, go out there and reach the lost souls. I mean, think about it, people. I mean, you can't be preaching to the choir all the time. We do need sometimes to lift each other up and be edified. But the great commission is to go out there and reach the other ones. I mean, and that's fruit. We need to bear that fruit. We need to get out there and reach that world that's dying, lost, going to hell. Let's see, I have another analogy here about a cell phone that ain't good for anything if it has a dead battery. You know, you got to charge it up. It needs energy before it'll work. And the only way to get the energy to the phone is connect it to a charger. And if you leave that phone connected to the charger long enough, it'll fill the phone up with energy. And then you can take the phone everywhere you go, use it as much as you want. But after a while, the energy will run out, and you have to connect that phone to the charger again and fill it up with more energy. Who's the energy source? There you go. The Holy Spirit, he's the one that gives us power. Exactly, that's it. We need to plug in every once in a while. I mean, we can plug in. What are some ways we can plug in? Praying? Reading the... There you go. Sharing, yeah, that's a good one. Because that builds you up. You know, those of you that have led somebody to the Lord, after you've led them to the Lord in the sinner's prayer, how does that make you feel? I mean, you just feel like, man, that was so cool. And thing is, angels up there, they're feeling it too, because they're all heaven's rejoicing. You sinner just got snatched out of the jaws of hell, and it's going to be walking them streets of gold because you listening to the Lord. If you forget to connect the phone to the charger, that's going to run out of energy, and you ain't going to be able to use it. It ain't going to be any good. But if you keep the phone charged up, full of energy, you can use it about as much as you like. And, you know, the only way to keep a phone charged up is to connect it to the charger often. You know, we're kind of like the cell phone. We need to get charged up with spiritual energy if we're going to be good Christians. There's only one way to get that spiritual energy is if we stay connected to the Lord. And we just talked about the different ways to stay connected. The Holy Spirit gives us the power and is the source for our spiritual energy. He shows us how we're supposed to live, and if we don't stay connected to Jesus, we'll run out of that spiritual energy, just like a cell phone without energy don't work right. A Christian that runs out of spiritual energy don't work right. And I got ahead of myself here. I already asked how can we stay connected. And okay, is there anything that we might be tied that ain't helping our walk with the Lord? Because, you know, the Word talks about, you know, you can't have the sweet water and the bitter water flowing from the same fountain. There's going to be a conflict. It's sort of like you can't love mammon and the Lord too. You know, you've got to be dedicated to the Lord. I mean, and if we mess up, he's there to forgive us and help us, strengthen us, and bring us back. But we need to try to keep that going. Stay tied up with God. and strengthening our relationship with the Lord. And based on tonight's scripture and message, you know, what can we learn about ourselves from this? I mean, is there anything, I mean, anything anybody could think of that's going to help us to be better people, to stay tied up with Christ? Because what you're tied to, that's who you're going to follow, right? So, I do got some more scriptures here, but I think the main thing to remember is what you're tied to is what you're going to follow. Exactly. And so, y'all hang tight with God. I mean, get tied up with Him, and He'll lead you the right way. The Word talks about, you know, the sheep know the good shepherd's voice, and they're not going to listen to the other. I mean, because there's a lot of voices out there. And you think about that. I mean, we go out to these rallies and stuff. There's a lot of stuff going on. There's good stuff, bad stuff. You got Christians there. You got heathens there. You've got some people that are just there. You know, they'll fall for anything. So if you're in their path, you could be the one to help change their life for eternity. So you need to be out there. You need to go out to the highways and hedges and compel the people to come in. And not just the house might be full, but that they might come into saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. And that's it. Hey. You never know. Is that any questions or anything?